Welcome to Car Traction. In today's video, we're at the historic racing event with the VSCC at Hillclimb Circuit, Loton Park. Now, it's been a while since I last went to a Hillclimb. I think the last time I went to one was La Vie en Bleu at Prescott. We haven't been to Loton Park for so long, so it's actually really good to get back here and see what's going on. So hopefully in this video I'll be able to film some of the cars going around track. There's a lot more in the paddock, and hopefully also have a look at some of the cars parked up in the paddock. Spotted this Sunbeam Talbot in the car park. Anyway, I think what we're going to do now is go and have a look around the paddock. Parked up, we have this gorgeous Napier. It's massive, this thing. First cars in the paddock, we have a Lee Francis with the horn on the side. That's a nice touch. And a pair of two Rileys. Here we have a gorgeous Picard Pictet, if I can say that right. Very obscure make of car. I'm sure long gone. That looks beautiful, that does. Next to a huge Hudson. We have yet another Hudson next to the blue example. Next to another Riley. And then we have a Bentley. These guys have got the right idea. Here we have a very famous hill climb car, the Spider. There are so many historic race cars, many of which are pre-war. This is only the practice session, but I think we're going to have a look at the start, because the start is just over there. after the Sunbeam Talbot, we have a little Austin 7. Beyond this freezer Nash, we have a very nice ERA. Here we have a very nice Talbot next to a Lagonda. Then a Worsley Hornet Special. And finally a very tasty Alvis. Austin 7 now. Riley. Austin 7 now. Riley.
Yeah.
coming back down the hill now. There are a lot of lovely Rileys just like this one, they look great. Austin 7. A Riley with a supercharger on the front. Some sort of special, not quite sure what that is. Another special, I believe this one is called the Wasp. Correct me if I'm wrong. Not quite sure what this one is. It's a sort of special based on Loton 7. Another, wow, another special. A special, we chatted to the owner of this earlier. Apparently it's based on a single and one. Some sort of other special, not quite sure what any of these are. Again, an ERA, gorgeous Grand Prix car, another Riley, and yet another Riley. Paddock, we've got this gorgeous Fraser Nash. Now, what would have been very common with Fraser Nash is that the rear wheels were often a bit narrower than the front wheels. That was a very quiet engine. Coming back up for some food, and we've spotted some vintage road cars. We have a nice Riley next to a Lee Francis, gorgeous car in my opinion, done up in a sort of racing trim. Now hopefully once we've had our food, all the practice sessions will be over, so I think after midday all the practice sessions will be over, there'll be no practice, anything like that, and it'll all be competition. And we have a very nice Lee Francis again beside this Riley. Just to give you a gauge of when this video is being filmed, the Italian Grand Prix is tonight. Yeah, that's how long ago I recorded this. But I will get around to uploading it as soon as possible. Also spotted a nice Wolseley, just post-war saloon. Please excuse the reflection of the Skoda. That's not great. Next to a gorgeous Bentley. Iconic British car. What I love about Bentleys, actually, you get these little foot plates that are really ornate. That's a nice little touch. Very nicely coloured chrome bumper. Classic MGB here. If you like this sort of thing, please check out the video I uploaded a couple of months ago, I think it was, when I reviewed the history and a guide to MGBs, all the information that you really need to know. If you haven't checked that out, please have a look at that. You guys loved it. It got like 8,000 views as well. Next to a Porsche 968. Don't see many of these. Quite similar to the 928, just not quite as big. Next to the Mazda MX-5, we have an MGB GT, this time in orange on mini lights. Looking very nice. I think mini lights just look great with any car at all. Especially minis, because that would make sense. That's the MX-5 again. And then we have a lovely TVI, I really like these. Also spotted is this gorgeous pre-war Rolls Royce. Pretty hard to miss it with its shiny metal and huge size. Proper swoopy machine with the early style AA badge on it. It's even got a couple of petrol pumps on the side to complete the look. The Shell and BP Limited one. I can see a couple of Pratt's ones over there. Look at that body, I love that, how it just goes around really nicely. It's really swoopy shape. Here we have a Triumph 2.5 PI, the big straight six that injected, that can be found in some later cars such as the Triumph TR6. Wow, another Rolls Royce. That looks very nice. Back to the Triumph. Yes, it's on mini lights. Also got overdrive. Wow, I like the exhaust. I bet it sounds really good with that straight six. Got the nice Lucas lamp on there as well. Proper usable classic, and I'm sure it goes pretty well as with that straight six engine. Here we have a Porsche Boxster. Nothing too special at the moment, but I'm sure in a few years these will go up in value. Modern classic. Sounds so quiet that I can hardly hear it. That was a very quiet engine. Bit of off-roading. Will it get up? Yes. Got a very nice Bentley. Seen quite a few of these today. Seen more of them parked up than on track, actually, I think. We have a Rover Metro. I think this is the Julie, isn't it? I actually quite like these in a way. I think they're quite a good looking shape. As modern cars go, that's probably pretty good. We have an old Range Rover Vogue. And beyond this E36, we have a very nice Jag. Gorgeous ACSC car. I absolutely love these cars. Such a swoopy shape. Got the enclosed number plate that I think can also be found on some cars such as the AC Greyhound. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.